In this video, I'm going to show you how to use functions in Python. Okay, so let's load up our Atom editor with our project that we had from our last lesson. We're going to create a new file here and let's call it functions.py. Okay, so this is our new blank functions file. Now, a function in Python is just a way of defining a block of code that you can repeat elsewhere in your source code. The difference between a function and a while loop or something like that is that a function, you can pass in various variables to customize the variables in the code that you execute. So I'm going to demonstrate how you do this and then you'll understand how it works and how they can be useful in your code. Okay, so let's pretend we're writing a piece of code for a store. And let's stick with the same theme that we've had in the previous two videos. We're going to be selling apples in our store. And let's say we want to write a simple script that greets the customer when they come in. So we want to greet them by their name and we want to tell them how many apples we have in stock. Okay, so let's start by just writing these lines out individually. So let's print hello Mark, and under that print, we have 6 apples in stock. Okay, so I'm gonna save that file and let's copy and paste these two lines and paste them two more. So we have this three kind of blocks of code here, and let's change the name. So let's say we have Brooke and then we have Greg coming to the store. All right, so save the file and then load up the terminal or command prompt window and let's run our function script by typing python functions.py. Okay, so you can see that it outputs on the screen the name of each person and how many apples we have in stock. All right, so you can see that this code is a bit repetitive. We've repeated the same thing 3 times. We literally had to copy and paste. And all we've done is change the text in here. And there's a lot of repeating text that we've entered more times than we need to. So for example, hello here, this is the same for all of them. And we have, and apples in stock, well, this actual string is the same for all of them, but let's pretend that this may change. So we're basically, you can see that it's repeating the code here. We're also repeating the print functions, and there's a lot of repetitiveness going on. Good source code has limited repetitiveness. There's a concept called DRY, which is do not repeat yourself. And that means don't repeat unnecessary blocks of code in your application, because then if we ever wanted to change this text, we would have to change it in all of these 3 places as opposed to just changing it in 1. So I'm going to show you how you can use functions to reduce code duplication. All right, so before we actually reduce the code duplication, I'm just going to show you how to make a simple function in Python. All right, so the way you define a function in Python is you use the DEF, it's short for define, and then the name of the function that you want to define. So let's create a function called greetMark. So I'm going to define DEF, and then I'm going to create a function called greet_mark. And each function that you define needs to end in 2 brackets. I'll explain why a bit later in this video. All right, so you write def, the name of the function, open and close brackets, and then a colon. If you hit enter after the colon, you can see that Atom automatically indents this here, because as with the while loops that we learned in the previous lesson, the function code is grouped by the indentation. So any code we want to include in this function needs to be indented by 1 tab underneath this function. Okay, so that's our first function. Let's create one for each of these blocks. So I'm going to copy and paste this here, copy and paste this here. I'm going to change this to Brooke. I'm going to change this to Greg. And then I'm going to indent these two here save that. The best practice is to use two spaces in between these functions when you're doing it in a single Python file like this. And then, so now we've defined our function. If we go to our command prompt and we run the code, you actually see that it doesn't output anything now. And that's because defining the function just isn't enough. You actually need to call the function after you defined it. So underneath these functions, we're going to call the function. So make sure that we're indented back to the base level of the file. And the way you call the function is you simply provide the function name and the code and the brackets without the DEF, because we've already defined it. We just want to call it now. So if I write greet Mark, and then again, I'm going to copy and paste that. I'm going to put greet Brooke, greet Greg, and then save the file. And if you load up command prompt, push up and do Python functions, and you can see the output's exactly the same as before. And it may seem backwards because we've actually created more lines of code instead of reducing the lines of code, which was the goal. But I'm just demonstrating how you define functions. Now I'm going to demonstrate how you can use functions to reduce the lines of code in the application. Okay, so one of the things that you can do with functions is you can pass in arguments to the function. So you can define various arguments that you can provide when you call the function, and then the function can use those arguments in the source code. All right, so if we delete these two here, because they're pretty much the same, and we can also delete the calls to them here as well. And let's rename our function. Instead of greet Mark, which is very specific and doesn't help with reducing duplication, let's just call the function greet customer. And then in between the brackets here, we're going to define a variable, and we're going to call, or it's actually an argument. We're going to define an argument for our function, and we're going to call the argument name. Okay, so if we call the argument name and then we hit save, and now when we call our function, actually, before we do that, we're going to change this print here, and instead of printing Mark, which we've hard coded here, we're going to update this to include our variable. So print hello. And we'll leave the string there, and before the end of the print, the last bracket in the print, use the plus symbol, and this will concatenate our name variable with this string. So what this is now doing is it's greeting a customer, and it's allowing us to provide the name of the customer, and it will include that name in the code that it prints out. Okay, so below this, let's write again, greet underscore customer. And then we need to provide the name of the customer we want to greet. So you define the variables when you call the function. You define the variables in the same order that you put them in the greet customer arguments. And since we only have one, we can just type it here. So we'll just put the name Mark, and then we'll copy and paste this, and we'll call it Brooke, and we'll call it Greg. Save that. Now load up the command prompt and let's run our file again. And now you can see it outputs the same again, except this time we have a lot less lines of code than we had before. Okay, so let's say we wanted to update this function and we want to actually be able to change the number of apples that we have in stock, because if Mark comes into the store, then after he's left the store, there may be less apples in there when Brooke comes in. Okay, so you can actually define multiple arguments for a function here. And you do that just by comma separating the list of argument names in the function argument bracket. So let's just call a new argument called numApples, just short for number of apples. And then similar to what we did here where we added the value of this to our string. I'm gonna delete this and then add the quotes here. So we now have two strings, and do plus. And we actually need to convert this number type into a string so that we can add it to our string, because you can't just add numbers into strings using the plus symbols. So we'll just type str and then num apples. So all this str does is it converts this whatever variable this is into the string type. So it basically converts our number into a string. So instead of it being the number 6, it will just be a string saying 6. Okay, so now we need to add this argument to the call when we call our function. So let's start with 7, and then let's say there's 6, and then let's say when Greg comes in, there's 2 left. Save that, and then go back to our command prompt, hit up and run. Now you can see that it actually changes the number of apples that outputs based on the arguments that we provide. Okay, so there's one more thing I'm going to show you about these function arguments, and that's that you can actually set a default for the function arguments. Okay, so a default means you can provide a default value for this, so you don't even need to provide it here. So let's just say there's a default of 7 apples. We always start with 7. The first time you call it, you can actually remove that, and you can run it again, and you see it still says 7. We change the default to 10, save that and run it. Now you can see it says 10. Now, the only thing to remember about setting defaults is you can only set defaults on the last or multiple last items in a function argument list. So another way of putting it is you cannot have a non-default function after you, a non-default argument after you've defined an argument with a default. So we wouldn't be able to provide name equals mark as a default and then put a non-default argument here. If you try that, it will give you an error telling you a non-default argument follows a default argument. So basically, once you've defined your first default argument, you need to either move it to the end of the list like this. Oops. Copy that. You either need to move it to the end of the list, or you need to set a default for the items in front. And then you would need to reorder when you call the function, reorder the, you would need to put the number of apples first in this case, because we've changed it around. Okay, so let's just move that back just so we have a finished working version. And yeah, you can set a default for any type of argument as long as the last ones, as long as you don't put any non-default ones after the default. Okay, so that's how you create functions in Python. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments below and I'll try and answer them, or someone else might answer them for you. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.